So the very first thing you want to do to be able to go ahead and stream to Facebook Gaming directly from OBS is that you want to go ahead and open up your Facebook Gaming page. If you don't have a Facebook Gaming page, I went ahead and put a link in the description to an article that walks you step by step on creating a gaming video creator page so you can be able to go ahead and live stream. So go ahead and follow along with that article, and then you can follow along with this video. So once you have your page, you're going to come to the left-hand side, and you're going to select Creator Studio. This is going to go ahead and bring us over to the dashboard inside of Facebook for us to go ahead and get all the prepping done for our live stream. So once that dashboard has become available, you're going to see here on the top right-hand side, it's going to say Go Live. You're going to go ahead and click that, and that's going to go ahead and bring us here to another window where we're going to go ahead and finalize and start the process. So it's going to ask you, do you want to go live or do you want to create a live video event? We're going to go ahead and select Go Live. Now, it's very important here at the bottom. It's going to say create a test broadcast before going live. I highly recommend that you do this, especially for the first time. That way you can fully go live without pushing it out to people, and you can test to make sure everything is good. And then once you know everything is good, you can come back, uncheck this, and then you'll be able to live stream directly so people can see you. So I'm going to go ahead and check that, and then I'm going to go ahead and select. That's then going to go ahead and bring us to a page here where we can start setting up the live stream and putting in the information that Facebook requires before you go live. So you're going to see an option here that's going to say webcam and streaming software. We're going to select streaming software because we're going to give this information to OBS so that way you can manage everything inside of OBS, have the overlays and everything that you need. So you're going to come down here where it says advanced settings. This is going to be very important. You're going to want to make sure that persistent stream key is toggled on. What that simply means is that if you have persistent stream key on, you can use the same stream key over and over again every time that you go live. If you have it unchecked, what's going to happen is that every time you go live to Facebook, you're going to have to grab the stream key and put it inside of OBS every single time. So I don't recommend that. So we're going to make sure that's checked on. Then on the right hand side, you're going to see here, it's going to say title and description. Now you're going to have to put a title in there for you to be able to go ahead and go live. So what I recommend is that you create a title that makes people want to click, have some kind of curiosity in there, so that way people like, oh wow, and they check on your stream. Then next, you're gonna have to go ahead and put in your description. Now in the description, what I like to put, so I like to tell your viewers what your stream is about, place your social links and your dono links in there. Then you can go ahead and input the game that you're gonna be playing if you want to. And then what you wanna do here, very important, that you come down here where it says enable preset pinned comment. This is gonna be unchecked to start off with, but you wanna make sure this is checked, because what this is a pinned comment in your stream, meaning that no matter how many comments come in, this one's going to be all the way at the top. And what I like to do is I like to go ahead and put my most recent YouTube video in there. So I put that YouTube video link in there. You can put anything that you want here, and then go ahead and hit save. So now that we have that set up, now what we want to do is we want to come to OBS and have that open. You're then going to come here to where it says settings inside of OBS. And this is going to go ahead and bring up the settings for OBS. Now you're going to come on the left-hand side and select stream. Now where it says service, you're going to click that and you're going to select Facebook Live. The server, you can leave it as default. And then what it's going to ask you for is going to be your stream key. So to be able to get your stream key, we're going to come back to Facebook and you're going to see here where it says stream key, copy. And then we're going to come back to OBS. You're going to come in here and you're going to go ahead and paste that stream key, and then you're going to go ahead and hit apply and you're going to select OK. So the first step is done where we've connected Facebook to OBS. Now we want to make sure that the OBS inside of the settings for OBS are correct, so that way your stream looks good on Facebook. So you're going to come here to the left hand side. You're going to select output. You're going to go ahead and go to output mode. You're going to select advanced. Then for the encoder, you're going to select X264. For the rate control, you're going to select CBR. And then for the bit rate, you're going to want to put 6,000. 6,000 and 6,500 is the max that Facebook allows. Now, this is all going to be dependent on your internet speed. So you want to make sure you go to speedtest.net. I'll put a link in the description of this video. And you want to go ahead and test your internet, and you want to focus on your upload speed. You want your upload speed to be about 10 plus. Anything higher than 10 allows you to be able to go to 6,000. But what I recommend is typically about half of what that upload speed is. So that way everything everything runs smoothly. Then for keyframe interval, you're going to want to put 2 seconds. For CPU usage, you're going to put very fast. Profile, you're going to put high. And for tune, you're going to put zero latency. So you're going to select OK there. And now what you want to do is you want to go to the description of this video and you want to download the free PDF guide that I went ahead and created, which is called the Ultimate Streamer Checklist. This is going to go ahead and tell you what to do before you go live, all the prepping you need to do so you can have success when you are live, what to do during your live stream so that way you know how to get people to follow you, to subscribe, to donate, to want to keep coming back. And then also I tell you what to do after your live stream so that way you can see the most growth, how to promote your stream so that way people find you when you're offline. So go into the description of this video and download that free guide. So now that we have our settings ready, now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and hit start streaming. You're going to say yes. And now what we're going to do is we're going to come back to Facebook. Now, remember, once you hit start streaming there, that's not going to push your stream to Facebook just yet, right? So this is just going to confirm that we've connected. So if it is connected, you should see what you see inside of OBS directly in this window here, as you see there. Then here on the bottom left hand side, you're going to see there's going to say start stream, right? Start test. Now, because we're testing, it says start test, meaning that when I push this button, it's going to push it live, but I'm only going to be the only one to see it. When you remove that test toggle that I told you in the beginning, this is going to say start live stream. Once you click that, that's going to go ahead and push it live. Now, remember, you have to do this every single time. You're not, when you hit start streaming on OBS, you come back to Facebook and you hit start streaming, and now your stream is going to be live. Now, if you want to go ahead and make your stream look professional and you want to have overlays on your Facebook stream, go ahead and watch this video right here where I even give you free overlays you can utilize, and I walk you step by step on getting them all set up. So click this video right here. I'll see you guys in the next video.